Hey scientists, it's Kanisha again. Welcome back to the Science Studio. I've been working on another painting. I want to capture the feeling of being at the park, but I just don't think this painting quite gets at what it really feels like to be there. I wanted to show the smells I smell, the sounds I hear, all the things that I sense around me when I'm at the park. What's that, Mia? I'm talking about the five senses? I know those. They're what we use to notice and observe the world around us. The five senses we can have are sight, smell, taste, hearing, and touch. I know what we can do. We can bring our painting to the park. We can see what we sense while we're there. Then we can decide how we can show those sensations in our painting. Oh, wow. It's sensational here. So much to see, smell, touch. Let's begin with the sense of sight, or vision. That's what we can see with our eyes. What are some things we can see here that we're missing from my painting? I see so many bright, vibrant colors. I also see so many different shapes of trees and flowers. Now, let's use your sense of smell. We can smell different scents through our nose. Around me, I can smell the warm, sweet aroma of flowers and the earthy smell of freshly cut grass. I can't put smell-o-vision into my painting, but I can show what created these amazing scents by adding some details to the picture. Okay, what's next? Let's move on to the sense of hearing, or the sounds we can hear with our ears. Lots of things in the park make sounds. Let's add some of them to our painting so we can remember what it sounds like here. So, if you can, take a moment to listen to the sounds you hear in the garden and think about how we can show them in our painting. I hear a buzzing bee and chirping birds. I think we can fit those two into our painting nicely. Our next sense is the sense of touch. Touch is what we can feel. Our skin helps us feel things, but we often feel the most using our hands and fingers because they can feel more details than our other body parts. I think Mia's been feeling her way around the park. Mia, can you tell us what your fingers touched? Mia says she felt the softness of the flower petals, the roughness of the tree bark, and the spiky blades of grass. I think we can show all of those feelings with details in our painting. We have one last sense to use, our sense of taste. We use our mouth and tongue to taste different flavors, only of food, of course. I love to taste the fresh fruits and veggies that grow in the community garden here at the park. I'll ask permission if we can taste some of the sweet treats there. Here we are. The park ranger said, go ahead. So I think I'll give one of those bright red strawberries a try. It's so sweet and juicy. I can show this delicious flavor by including a red shiny berry on one of the bushes. All right, my painting is almost finished. I'll add a few details back at the Science Studio.
just adding the finishing touches and voila.
What do you think? Much more lifelike than before, huh?
It's amazing how using our senses can make our experiences so much more powerful.
Thanks for helping me bring this painting to life. You can explore the world around you with your senses too. Give it a try in your science sketchbook. You might not experience the same senses that I did, and that's okay. Some people may be without a sense, and everyone's senses work a little differently. Until next time, keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey, hey.